गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे विल बी स्टडिंग न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन विच स्टेट्स दैट टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज ऑलवेज एन इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन, राइट। सो दिस वी एक्सपीरियंस इन आवर डेली लाइव्स दैट व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ फोर्स अप्लाइड टू एनीथिंग एनी ऑब्जेक्ट there is some reaction to it, and we will study different examples to understand this law. That basically it says that suppose this is an object, okay, if I try to push this object by a force F, then this object will apply an equal and opposite force. Equal and opposite means a force of same magnitude, that is F, but in the opposite direction. That means this object will exert a force on my hand. Fine. So there are various examples, very simple examples which you might have experienced, that whenever there is a book, say this is an object kept on a table, what will happen? Will it fall down? No, but its weight is acting downwards. This is the weight W, and it is acting downwards. So why is it not falling down? Because something is balancing this force. Weight is a force, na? So some force must be balancing this force which is acting downwards. So that force, this should be equal to the downward force, but opposite. That means it will be acting in the upward direction, right? So an equal and opposite force is balancing it, therefore it is not falling down. So it is not necessary that the thing is always balanced. The force that is exerted, that is equal and opposite, but that doesn't mean that the object will always remain stationary. No, right? This is a particular example for that. We will study various other examples, then you'll understand it better. So for now, you will simply understand that the weight of the object was acting downwards, while the table was exerting a force upwards to balance it over here, and that is why this object was not falling down. Right, then there is another example. When we walk, what happens? We push the earth or the ground, we push it with our feet when we move forward, right? We push the ground backward, and what is happening? The ground, it is applying the same force on our feet, and this helps us to move forward, right? So that means again an equal and opposite force was acting, and now here you were not able to move the earth, you know, you won't be able to do that, so you are moving, right? So there is one experiment over here. You can understand that. This is just a demonstration. See, can you see this diagram? Here there is this wall, and a hook is attached to it. With that hook, there is this spring balance is attached to it. To this spring balance, this one is named B, and to this spring balance, another spring balance named A is attached. Fine. Now what we are doing? We are applying a force on this ring. Okay, we are pulling this ring. So what is happening? We can see that the same reading can be obtained in both the spring balances. Can you see here? 4 is here also and here also. So same force, same reading is obtained in both the spring balances. Why? Because when you are pulling the ring of spring balance A, the spring balance pulls B. Fine. The force we are applying on this, that is actually exerted on B. So spring balance is pulling B with the force this much, 4 kgf. And in return, what is happening? This is pulling it this side, fine. So an action and reaction is happening over here, and both of them, because an equal and opposite force must be acting, that is why they both are showing the same readings. Fine. Now let us see various other examples that are given in your book. So first one is a book on the table. This we just read it. I told you just now. So once again we can see it. See here, this is a book placed on a tabletop, and the weight of the book is acting downwards. So this is the action, and the weight is acting in the direction AB. What is the reaction? The tabletop is exerting a force on the book itself. Fine. Then pushing a wall. If you try to push a wall, what happens? If you try to push a wall, you will exert a force on the wall. In return, the force will exert some force in you. So you can observe some stretch or something, some kind of pull in your muscles. Fine. That is the reaction of the wall on your palm or your muscles. Fine. Then motion of a boat moving away from the shore. When a boat is moving away, what happens? The boatman, he pushes the shore with the help of his oar. Fine. He pushes the shore, and so this is the action, and in return the shore tries to push the boat. So in this way the boat moves further. So this is the reaction. Then motion of boat in water. When the boatman is rowing the boat in water, what happens? He is pushing the water with the help of the oar, and the water is pushing the boat in the forward direction. So the action is the boatman pushing the oar pushing the water in the backward direction, and reaction is the water pushing the boat in the forward direction. Fine. Then firing a bullet from a gun. When you fire a bullet from a gun, what happens? The action is the force applied by the gun on the bullet. And in reaction, what happens? An equal and opposite force is experienced by the hand which is holding it, or you can say the equal and opposite force is exerted by the bullet on the gun. That is known as the recoil. Fine. So that is the reaction, which is the equal and opposite force exerted by a bullet on the gun. Then rocket motion. What happens in case of rockets? You can see the figure that is explaining it better. So in case of rockets, what happens when the fuel burns? A lot of gases come out of the rocket. So the combustion that is taking place, that is that process, the rocket, you can say the engine and all, that is exerting force on the gas in order to pull it out. And the gases are exerting an equal and opposite force on the rocket, so the rocket moves up. So force, this is the force exerted by the gases on the rocket. Can you see here? Force on gases, that is the action, and force on rocket, that is the reaction. You might be asked to specify the action and reaction, so you must be able to understand that. Then motion of a man on the ground. This also we just discussed, that when a person is walking, see this figure, when a person is walking, what happens? The foot is pushing the ground in the backward direction, and what is happening? The earth is pushing the foot in the forward direction, right? So in this way we are able to move forward. Then motion of boat away from the shore while stepping down from it. Done boating and all, then you might have observed, when you come out of the boat, what happens? You exert a force on the boat, due to which the boat moves a bit away from the shore, and in return the reaction is that the boat exerts a force on you so that you are able to step out of the boat. Okay. Then catching a ball. When you catch a ball, the action is the ball exerting force on your palm, and in return an equal force is exerted by the palm to stop the ball. Okay, the ball was already coming with some force, no? So that force is applied on your palm, and when you stop it, you have to apply an equal and opposite force, right? So this is Newton's third law of motion. There are two numericals given over here and they are very simple, so I thought I'll discuss it over here only. See the first one. A boy pushes a ball with a force of 10 Newton towards east. What force is exerted by the ball on the boy? So the ball is applying 10 Newton towards east, so the ball will exert equal and opposite, that means 10 Newton towards west. Fine. Then in this figure they are saying a 15 Newton weight is hanging from a rigid support. What force is exerted by the block on the string? So block is the weight of the block is acting downwards. Fine. Let me show you here. The weight of the box is acting downwards like this. So a reaction will be upwards and it should be equal. So what force is exerted by the block on the string? Block is exerting a force equal to its weight, right? That is 15 Newton and downwards. The weight is acting downwards, right? Then string on the block, what force is exerted by the string on the block? The an equal and opposite force, this one will be by the string. The string will be pulling the block towards itself, right? So this is a 15 Newton upward force will be exerted by the string on the block, and the force that is exerted by a string on something, when you pull something with the help of a rope, or if something is hanging by a rope, that the force that is on in the string, that the force with which the string is pulling the body towards itself, that is known as the tension. Okay. And they have asked you, name them and show them in the diagram. So naming them is the force that was acting downwards was the weight of the block, and the force that is acting upwards, that is the tension, right? That's all for this.